Alright, be honest, why the hell are you still modeling trees by hand? You waste hours tweaking every branch, every leaf, while your deadline laughs at you in the corner. But what if I told you there is a free tool that spits out high quality, realistic trees in seconds? Sounds like cheating, right? Well, it kinda is. Today I'm showing you this insane free software, how to use it, and why it might replace your entire tree workflow for good. So buckle up, because this is stupidly easy, and by the end of this video, you will wonder how you ever lived without it. Welcome back to Primal VFX, I'm your host Kurt, and if you want more mind-blowing VFX tips, smash the like button, subscribe for more awesomeness, and let's dive in right now. Before we dive into the heart of this video, ask yourself, do you ever dream of crafting 3D cinematic sci-fi worlds? Well, buckle up, because I've got something extraordinary for you. Welcome to an unexpected odyssey, episode 1, environment modeling with Maya. This full course is your gateway to mastering the art of modeling and designing immersive environments. I will be sharing with you how to plan and organize personal projects, keep motivation, and be efficient in tackling such a large environment scene. Discover a seamless modeling workflow that thrives on precision, channeling attention towards shapes, forms, and harmonious proportions. Uncover ingenious kitbashing and modular asset strategies that infuse life into your scenes. Let's turn your dreams into stunning reality. The adventure begins now, and you can join the journey over at primalvfx.com. Alright, time to level up your 3D game. Today, we are diving into TreeIt, an insane free tool that lets you generate trees in real time, like it's nothing. This bad boy is made by the developers at Evolved. And the best part? It's 100% free. Whether you're working in Blender, Maya, Unreal Engine, and yes, game devs, this one's for you too. Now, before you start smashing that download button, here's the deal. TreeIt is Windows only and comes in two formats, a zip file, portable, and an .exe installer. Pick your poison. Once you fire it up, you're greeted with a clean, no-nonsense interface that's ready to crank out some stunning trees. But how do you actually use it? That's where the magic happens. I'll show you exactly how to build stunning, high-quality trees step by step. You don't want to miss this. Alright, let's cut the fluff and get straight to it. TreeIt makes generating trees stupidly easy. But before we dive in, let's cover the basics so you don't look lost. Navigating in TreeIt, middle mouse button, zoom or dolly in and out. Left mouse button, orbit around the object. Right mouse button, pan across the scene. You'll also see quick access icons for different view modes, front, side, top, and perspective. You can toggle between wireframe, shaded mode, wind animation, and lighting settings to get a better preview of your tree. Generating trees is stupidly simple. TreeIt gives you full control, and the best part, it takes seconds. Alright, let's kick this off. Go to File, then New Tree. And boom, you've got a trunk in your scene. Over on the right panel, you'll see options like Trunk, Branches, branchlets, and leaves, plus a few more if you really want to get fancy. Up top, there are tabs for each major section. First things first, adjust the global scale. Make it massive or tiny, go nuts. You can also crank down the poly count on the trunk or leaves to keep things light. Next, there's a joints section. Enable it, and you can bend every point on the trunk to shape the tree however you like. If you make a hot mess, just reset and move on. Now jump to the Trunk tab. This is where you sculpt your trunk's shape. Want multiple trunks? Up the trunk count. You can also tweak trunk split to branch out even more. Adjust size and segments to refine your topology, then pick tapered ends for that sleek, pointy look. Time for textures. Hit Load Texture, then either import your own or browse the built-in library. Choose something you like, and it'll automatically load diffuse, normal, and roughness maps. Magic! Amp up the height map for extra detail. You can also tweak the trunk's radius, add noise, or even crank up the creakiness to make your tree look old and gnarly. Throw in some gravity if you want that dramatic sag. Feeling good about the trunk? Awesome! Onward to branches. Increase the branch count, adjust size, segments, and maybe taper the ends for realism. Add branchlets if you want finer detail. Basically, you can control every little twist, bend, and drop right here. Gravity, curvature, twist mode, go wild. Next up, leaves. By default, there's nothing, so crank up the leaf count and watch Treeit magically slap on leaf cards. You can increase leaf size, then load texture just like before. Grab a leaf image and Treeit loads all the maps in one go. Adjust the crosshair to align the texture tip correctly, then scale down the length and width so your leaves don't look like elephant ears. And if you want more variety, just add another leaf generator. Same process, same magic. Once you're happy, punch that randomize button in the main tab for an instant variation. Like having your own private forest. And if you need more pre-made samples, just open the internal library, pick something like maple, and watch Treeit load a gorgeous tree that's basically ready to rock. Alright, your tree looks killer, but can you actually use it? It's time to show you how to export it like a pro without messing up your scene. Alright, so once your epic tree is done, and you're ready to bring it into Maya or Blender, just head to File, Export. You can choose FBX or OBJ. Both are perfect for a quick import into your 3D app of choice. Name it something fancy like Tree Beauty. And boom, you're good. Now, let's jump into Maya. Go to File, Import. Select your FBX. And voila! Your gorgeous tree pops right in. Next, let's slap a ground plane in there. Create a light dome and pick an HDRI to make it all look pro. Adjust your render settings to full HD. Add a camera and tweak the angle until it's just right. Time to tackle the shaders, one for the leaves and one for the trunk. Drag them into Hypershade, connect up all your maps. Diffuse, roughness, normal, whatever you've got. Rinse and repeat for the trunk texture. Once everything's linked up, fire up the IPR and bask in the 3D glory you've just created. So there you have it, folks. 3D trees in seconds, no sweat. Let me know in the comments. Are you still hand modeling or is this your new secret weapon?
Thank you so much for watching. If you enjoyed the content, you know what to do. Subscribe to my channel for more awesomeness. And I'll see you guys in the next video.